Near. Replicant is a shapeshifter. It makes you think it's a simple action role-playing game set in a bleak fantasy universe, but steadily reveals itself to be a lot more. It's a game that shifts wildly in both tone and playstyle. It's weird and heartbreaking, frustrating and playful, often all at the same time. This release is also a second chance for a game that failed to reach a big audience when it first launched in 2010, now updated for modern tastes. It still requires a little patience, but it's worth putting up with some clunky gameplay to find all that Replicant has to offer. If the Nier name sounds familiar, it's probably because of Nier Automata, a 2017 action RPG from director Yoko Taro and Studio Platinum Games that became a surprise hit. Its blend of tight action, haunting storytelling, and downright absurdity helped it reach an audience of more than 5 million players. It also renewed interest in the original Nier, hence this new release, which has been given the incredibly awkward but fitting title Nier Replicant V1.22474487139. This version isn't exactly a full remake but instead an updated version that sands off some of the original's rough edges. Replicant is not an easy game to explain. The story starts out in the near future, where some kind of plague is decimating humanity. It then fast forwards a few thousand years into a future when the world is pretty much unrecognizable. There are elements of a traditional post-apocalyptic landscape, like the ruins of our society, but the world of Nier more closely resembles a fantasy realm with magic and monsters and lots of big swords. The fascinating world is a large part of the appeal, and you'll spend a lot of time crisscrossing it over the course of Replicant. It's bleak and desolate, with small pockets of humanity still surviving. The game puts you in the role of a young fighter on a desperate mission to cure his sister, who's struggling from a strange and mysterious disease that's steadily spreading throughout the world, which also happens to be dealing with an onslaught of dark monsters called Shades. It's a dangerous place, and you're eventually joined by a cast of characters including a talking spellbook, a warrior perpetually dressed in lingerie, and a young boy with magical powers. In some ways, Replicant is like a traditional fantasy RPG. You're on an epic quest, which eventually includes not only finding a cure but fighting the big baddie in charge of all the monsters, and along the way you'll acquire new abilities and weapons. But those aren't the things that make Replicant interesting. It's when the game goes in unexpected directions that it's at its best. You'll visit strange towns, including one where the residents strictly follow thousands of rules, and another where everyone refuses to leave their homes. The most jarring moments, though, are when the game shifts genres.